Quiet, Shen.
Someone's coming.
Yeah, give me one good reason why I should let you. Because, one, you have no standing within the brony community. Two, you don't even make videos. Three, why did this video suddenly become grayscale? What was that?
What the heck, Chewie? How are you?
This is unprofessional! The audience can see the black line!
I have control over your show now. Besides, you owe me one for that little comment you made about us Canadians.
That was a joke!
Jokes are supposed to be funny.
Ow!
Side with what's clearly a smear campaign that one of your best friends you've known for years says that it's all complete lies. Also, Dr. Caballeron isn't exactly multifaceted or even the least bit sympathetic. He's boring. Just a simple, greedy bad guy out for riches. That's it. With a character like him, you don't need to... Oh, fuck.
What was that?
No, please don't make me say it.
You're gonna compliment something that you've been complaining about for a while now, aren't you?
Shut the fuck up!
Come on, say it!
All right! We don't need to know Caballeron's backstory, and it makes me sound like a hypocrite for wanting the exact same thing from Cozy Glow. But even then, if you think I'm just gonna break down and become a sheeple and just blindly follow the praise you all give Little Miss Not Darla Dimple Filly, then you're fucking wrong! Because she is by every definition an incomplete character! And how and why she became a villain in the first place still makes no fucking sense!
So I must ask, why aren't they falling off? Magic?
Oh,
excuse me for a minute?
He'll be back.
Some people say that I'm a bad guy. They may be right. They may be right. But it's not as if I don't try. I just fuck up, try as I might. But I can change, I can change. I can learn to keep my promises, I swear it. I'll open up my heart and I will share it. Any minute now I will be born again. Yes, I can change, I can change. I know I've been a dirty little bastard. I like to kill, I like to hate. Yes, I'm insane, but it's okay, cause I can change. It's not my fault that I'm so evil. It's society. Society. You see, my parents were sometimes abusive, and it made a prick of me. But I can change, I can change. I can learn to keep my promises, I know it. I'll open up my heart and I will show it. Any minute now I will be born again.
But what if you never change? What if you remain a sandy little butthole?
Such a twit, Mother Teresa won't have shit on me. Just watch me change. Here I go, I'm changing.
Oh boy, let me tell ya, Ritalin is one hell of a drug. Oh, what I miss.
No! Chewie! Let's just give Sans another point and be done with it.
Tell me, besides Grogar, why exactly are you wanting to join our team anyway?
Really now?
I mean, wow! Were we wrong? All this time, this demonic hellspawn creature has been protecting artifacts from being stolen, such as the Sapphire Stone, the Rings of Scorchero, and the Truth Talisman of Technotiklong, among others. I can't believe we were so mistaken. Thank you, Owie Sodal. Thank you so much for clearing all that up. Wait a minute!
Hey. Owiezotl, come here for a sec.
No, closer.
Just a little bit closer.
Bullshit!
There was no previous indication you were protecting anything! Oh wait, silly me, there were actually two things you were protecting!
Jack and shit. Jack left town.
So, we could be mistaken, but if that truth-telling necklace is any indication, Cavaleron's always been greedy, Daring Do was in the right to steal these artifacts all along so they couldn't hurt anyone else. And you, Owie Sodal, you're a betrayal to your Aztec mythological roots! And shove it where the unrelenting sweltering heat don't shine!
There's no reason to get angry, guys! We need all the help we can get if we're gonna stop Unicron. And besides, I'm pretty sure Unicron will never see this coming whatsoever!
Fucking what? Guys, not every villain needs to be redeemed! And if you're gonna do that, you have to do it right! You think you had problems with Garble getting reformed in Sweet and Smoky voice? Well, just be thankful it wasn't this!
Do you see the levels of incompetency here, people? I haven't seen this level of stupid since Rainbow Falls. Hell, I won't hesitate to put this in the bottom three of the absolute worst episodes of the show, right alongside A Matter of Principles and Rainbow Falls. It is that bad.
Oh, God. Does that mean Rainbow Falls is officially dethroned as overall second worst episode for you?
Oh, fuck no. It's at that level of incompetence, not surpassing it.